said, you know, you look in the mirror sometimes and you say you can't have it all. Mm-hmm. There's always a compromise. Mm-hmm. Why do you believe that?
To be a working woman with a family, with a relationship.
I have to tell you, a lot
choices.
Of women would say, what is she talking about?
She has
she
it all.
She has it all.
And I'm blessed beyond belief. Yeah. I have enough. But if I, every time I make one decision, I take away from something else.
What is it that you think you don't have?
Well, I would love to get rid of some of the mom guilt.
Oh.
Because that really shades a lot of my decision making. I put way too much pressure on myself. I think we all do.
Yeah.
And I want to follow my passion too. And I want my kids to see what it looks like to have a mom that's a boss, that is following her passion and that is working really hard towards her goals. But there's always a choice, it's a balance.
And I'm a little surprised at that because to see when you were getting the Video Vanguard Award and to see how your little girl was looking at you.
So, baby girl, we don't change. We take the gravel in the shell and we make a pearl. And we help other people to change so that they can see more kinds of beauty.
Like that kind of, it floors me because I'm like, how does she have this mom guilt? Because look at this little girl who obviously you are her heroine.
Because no matter what, you just, it's not good enough. I don't know, we put that on ourselves. That's how we mom now. But having her with me and having the kind of life that I have, that's why I say I'm blessed beyond belief. My kids go with me on tour and they have this incredible, diverse, beautiful carnival of people between my dancers and my band and wardrobe and our chef Robbie who taught her how to cook when she was two. Aww. And it's just this gypsy family of traveling people, and that part's beautiful.
After you gave that speech at the VMAs, did you talk to your daughter? Did she say anything?
She wasn't super impressed that night, but the first time we had the conversation, which was a couple of weeks before, I think it meant a lot to her, and I think it was David Bowie that kind of made it all make sense to her. I think also her hearing that I get made fun of, because she's six and she thinks I'm awesome. She doesn't yet despise me. So she's like, what do you mean you get made fun of? You're perfect.
Oh, what happens when that day comes when she's like,
oh, it's
Mom,
coming.
I don't wanna...
It's like right around the corner.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Is she a good big sister?
She is, finally. Yeah. She likes him. Now that he can laugh, she likes him. She was very disappointed in him when he first came out. We had a lot of talks, a lot of tears. At one point, she looked at me and said, I never thought I'd have to beg you for a cuddle with crocodile tears in her eyes. And I was like, oh.
Did that kill you?
Yeah, it took about 6 months off my life. I threw her a big sister party. I really thought I dotted my I's and crossed my T's, but it's fine, it'll be fine. One day she'll thank me, I keep telling her that.
So what's next then for Alicia and not Pink?
I'm trying to get this baby to grow some teeth so I can start feeding him different kinds of food. I'm super anxious about that. I'm hoping Carrie asks me on a date soon because it's been a while.
What is date night for you guys?
Date night is if we're in Venice, we ride bicycles to our favorite dive bar, play darts or pool.
You guys just like each other.
He's funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's naughty. I like his brain.